like to dedicate this short talk on competencies. Competencies are contextual to all those who are interested in learning about competencies. This is dedicated. Many people say that why do I need to do competency mapping for my company all over? Why don't I simply look at, I think, the competency models of some company or the other? Because nowadays all models seem to have same terms: customer focus, entrepreneurial thinking, strategic thinking, teamwork, leadership, and so on and so forth. I think many competencies seem to be, and if there are some new terms, they are also getting common across different cultures. So I think all that I need to do is to borrow the competency models of some of the successful companies. People forget that competencies copied are going to mislead you phenomenally. This is because competencies are contextual. Competencies are contextual for a job. The most important part of competency mapping is identifying indicators of a successful performance of a given role at a given point of time. What contributes to success today may not exactly contribute to the same amount of success tomorrow. This is because tomorrow the challenges may be different. The situation may have changed. Your team may have changed. The chemistry may have changed. The world has changed. Therefore, the competency identification is only a part of the job that we do. The most important part of the competency mapping is identification of the indicators, and these indicators may change from time to time. That is why competency mapping needs to be updated from time to time. Competencies also need to be role specific and job specific, department specific and context specific. What is applicable to do a successful job, for example, in Calcutta may not yield the same kind of results in Mumbai and may yield totally different kind of results in Coimbatore. Some competencies in certain jobs may vary from place to place, whereas some of the competencies may not. For example, the competencies required in terms of the technical skills and functional skills by and large are likely to be similar across different regions and across times. However, with time they may get sophisticated. That is why it is very important for those interested in competency mapping to map the competencies of each role and make it contextual. Once you have done the main job of mapping the competencies at a given point of time, later, periodically, maybe once in 2 years, once in 3 years or 5 years, you need to review these with the help of all those who are current performers of the role or who are seniors or the bosses of the current performers and so on. So please do not copy the competency models of other organizations just because the terms are the same. You must discover your own terminology. You must come up with your own language. You must come up with your own dictionary of competency mapping. You will learn all this if you go through a competency mapping course, and I hope you will be able to get enough details and insights into competency mapping and will do a great job of competency mapping. All the best.